one thing left to do. Now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way.
Given them. Today we witness a marriage that has been almost 6 years in the making.
The mic's not on. I'll be the mic's on.
Yes, it's working.
It's working?
Okay, thank you.
Wait, you guys can't hear, right? I don't think it's on.
I don't louder.
Louder.
Okay.
All right, let's start over.
Remember all the stuff I just said. Okay, today we're going to witness a marriage that has been almost 6 years in the making. Kirsten and Tyler's love grew as they grew, both as individuals and as a couple. The powerful connection that drew them together as college students has only grown stronger as they became adults. They stand before you today, eager and ready to fully commit to one another as husband and wife, forever friends and soulmates. Kirsten and Tyler, today you are surrounded by your friends and family who have gathered here to witness your marriage and to share in the joy of this special occasion. Today, as you join yourselves in marriage, there is a vast and a passion for living. A love that provides you with energy, patience to face your new challenges and responsibilities of your marriage. Love is more than verses on a Valentine card and romance in movies. We begin to know that love is here and now, real and true. And the most important thing in our lives, love is the creator of our favorite memories and the foundation of our fondest dreams. Without love, we merely exist. We're too old to hold hands. It is remembering to say, I love you. Out loud, Tyler, I love you. At least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry. It's forming a circle of love that gathers in the whole family. It is at no time taking the other for granted. For what you take for granted disappears. It is doing things for each other, not in the attitude of duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy. For those of you that don't know, Tyler is a football official, and a very good football official. But being married and being in a partnership, Kirsten, it must be equal. So the first thing I want to present to you today is a whistle.
All right.
When we officiate, the whistle represents starting the action, and more important for you, stopping the action.
Like that.
Secondly, Tyler, there are going to be rules in this marriage. You're fine. You don't even know what they are yet. But just in case Kirsten gets into a situation where she sees a rule violation, which we call a penalty, I also am going to give her a flag.
Thank you.
Since you have these, I think you now will have a more equal partnership.
Thank you.
We, as your friends and family, gathered here today to accept for you a love that brings out your magnificent, a love that gives you courage to stand apart, and the willingness to stand together. May you always need one another, not to fill an emptiness, but to help each other know your fullness, to mark an end of an era, and a new beginning to recognize officially, for which Kirsten and Tyler are going to serve in a public affirmation of their friendship and love. There are no ties on earth so sweet, none so tender as those you are about to take. There are no vows so solemn as those you are about to make. There is no institution, companion, lover, dancing partner, and even a teacher. You have learned much from one another in these past few years. Now you shall say a few words that take you across the threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you shall say to the world, "This is my husband. This is my wife."
I, Tyler, take you, Kirsten, to be my friend, my lover, to respect you, to comfort and encourage you, to care for and protect you from this day forward and for all of the days of my life.
Tears and in laughter, in sickness and in health, when life seems easy and when it seems hard, when our love is simple and when it is an effort, I choose you to be no other than yourself, loving what I know of you and trusting who you will become. I promise to encourage you and inspire you, and to love you unconditionally through all of our adventures in life.
These are the hands of your best friend. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as you laugh and cry. These are the hands that will build a loving home for your children. These are the hands with just a touch. These are the hands that will give you support as he encourages you to chase down your dream.
Ignore it.
Tyler, I'd like to look at your hands. Look at them right.